हेलो एवरीवन, लास्ट टाइम वी वर डूइंग आवर चैप्टर मोशन एंड टाइम एंड स्पीड टॉपिक वाज लेफ्ट टू रीड. सो लेट्स लर्न व्हाट इज स्पीड. सो बेसिकली स्पीड इज अ डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय अ मूविंग ऑब्जेक्ट इन यूनिट टाइम इज नोन एज इट्स स्पीड. दैट मीन्स इफ एनी ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्स फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर एंड व्हाट टाइम्स डज इट टेक टू कंप्लीट इज नोन एज इट्स स्पीड. And basically the things that we require to measure the speed are distance and time. That means how much distance is covered by the object and how much time does it take. Okay, so basically speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is divided by the time. And if you have any two dimensions among all these three, then you can easily find the third one. For example, if you want to find the speed, then you need to divide distance by time. Okay, and if you want to find out the distance and you have speed and time, then by the multiplication you can find the distance of the particular object. Okay, and if you want to measure the time, if the distance is given with the speed, so by dividing distance with speed you can easily find the time taken by the object. Okay, so these are the things that we needed to do in speed. Speedometer is a gadget that shows you the speed of your vehicle, and the distance is shown by the odometer present in the vehicles. Okay, let's move to the last topic of this chapter, that is distance time graph for uniform motion and even for the non-uniform motion. So first of all, what is a uniform motion? That means an object, it moves in a straight line and covers equal distance. Okay, so here object has fixed time and fixed distance. So how a graph you can plot for this? So let's see. So here we have time distance graph for uniform motion. Okay, so for example here 9 to 9, 5, so 5 minute distance is there and it covers 5 kilometers. Okay, so another one is also same, 9, 5 to 9, 10, the distance and time remain same in both the conditions. Okay, so if the time and the distance mismatch, that means it would be non-uniform motion, but here in the uniform motion we have fixed time and fixed distance. So by this your graph can be formed in, can be plotted in a straight line. And if we talk about the non-uniform motion, we do not have distance and time in a proper dimensions. Okay, so they are not fixed here. So like the distance, it goes first of all it goes 2 kilometers and afterwards 4 point something and then 5 point something. So here distance is not in the fixed direction and even the time is not equal for all the travels. Okay, so here the graph which we have is in zigzag motion, so not in the straight line. That means it is non-uniform motion. Okay, so students, here our chapter completes. In the next video we will come with our next chapter.